all that's set up and done. The stream is up. Everybody's got their little... Careful, Nancy. Well, I'm ready. Come on, Pan. We're waiting on you. Well, the one I've, there's two I've been listening to. Let me see if I can. One of them is High Rollers Aeolus. The other one is Dark Dice. It's a horror one, and I can't remember his name, but he's in season two. He's from the original Jurassic Park movie, who played Malcolm. Yeah, that's who it is. Goldblum. Once I heard he was in that, I immediately started listening to Dark Dice, and I'm like, okay, gotta go through season one. And then got to season two. Yeah, it's an actual campaign. I think they might have video, but I don't know. It's on Spotify. But Season 2 of Dark Dice has two separate parties in it. You have Party A and Party B. Party B is the one that has Goldblum in it. Same universe, same time, they're just in different locations. And they will eventually meet up. And I think there's going to be combat when that happens. I don't know, but that's what it seems like. Hey! Yes. I won't say to funds, but I'm trying to get stronger myself. I don't think so. That's completely understandable. Nothing I can think of. Well, would I notice anything? I mean, me with that high perception too. I actually walk up to the well and I look down inside of it. And I'm also going to use my Eldritch Sight to get Detect Magic going. I'm going to try to see if I can get in through this window here. So what do I need to do to try to get in through this window? I can cast Mage Hand, and I'll cast it on the inside where I can see, and use the Mage Hand to unlock it.
Well, you can put snow in the other room.
All right, and I head in through the window.
She loves that curtain. And I think she made a... Yeah. Hi. Well, you might have to clean the spot.
See, I know.
Hi, baby. Hi. Hi, Nancy. That she's feeling a lot better.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You're feeling better, baby. Yeah.
Well, I... Happy. Yep. And I head up and unlock it and open it. What about in this room? Is there anything that I can notice that might be moved or anything?
She bumped against the walls a few times.
I know.
It's okay. It's okay.
Hmm.
Ten.
Mm-hmm. What's this about something you don't understand? I head over there as well. And I use my invocation Eyes of the Runekeeper to read it. There you go. Oop, someone's got their... Okay. Erin had her camera on for a second there. On the phone or something. Because I just saw a man looking down on your from your spot. Oh. So it might have been Panrat. That's... Question is, do you have a rope long enough? Because... We could. I don't have a rope myself. Okay, I go straight to it and I head down. All right. Anybody have the ability to unlock things? Is that something I can't do? I could break it with my Eldritch Blast. But that's only a last resort. I know, but yeah. Could have someone stand on top of it. I aim for them and they dodge as I shoot. Said it hits. I wonder, would I be able to slide my dagger in between the openings? If it's a two-door type deal? Dex, alright. Oh wait, that's the saving throw. There's the check. Hey, that worked. I open it and head down. Oh, it's dark down here. Also, I have no dark vision, so it is dark for me. I don't see anyone because of that. I do. Yep. Oh, so the three of us that don't have dark vision. I say now. Delvar, yep. Yep. But you end up burning spell slots when you do. Yep. So essentially, it's the same crest that would be on my signet ring. Question is, would I? Be right back. Alright, I'm back. My parakeet finally went back into her cage, so I had to close her up. Yeah. It's supposed to be right after me. So do I. I got, I actually end up saying, "Those of you skeletons, I am a descendant of the first king. Cease and desist. Stop attacking us." Do I see anything happen towards them? From them? So they're not caring. So I will hold my action of Eldritch Blast on the guy in front of me, in front of all of us here, till they, if any of them, move any closer to us. Nope. Seeing as they are still attacking, I move to here, target this guy, and I cast Eldritch Blast. And that was max damage, too. Nope, that's the end of my turn. Yep. By the way, Bill, you just got the two characters mixed up. Yep. Yeah. Ouch. To answer your question, Aaron, how it would hit is it had advantage because he was wearing Oh, true. Yeah, because he's got an 18 AC. So it still missed. Ooh. All right, I'm going to target the same one I did before and cast another Edric Blast. Missing. It saw it coming, so it dodged. And at that point, I move over to here so I can see it a little better and end my turn there. That was minus 20 off of its health. I don't understand, though, as it's showing 10. I did that much damage to it. He's muted. Ouch. For a total of 2 points of damage. Minimum damage. Two D8, and it rolled nat one damage on both dice. And as soon as the last one dies, I immediately reactivate Eldritch Sight. Yeah, I'm taking the one that's right next to me. And does my detect magic sense anything? Hey guys, I found someone. Correct. It's not Stelvar. I have the capability to carry them, but I don't want them. As far as we know, yes, we got them all. Are you the blacksmith? You should. Part of me wants to find out. Part of me wants to find out what's in the chest, but part of me doesn't. That's what I mean. I'm not a thief, though. Not this character. It's the rogue in me that wants to. Yes. That would definitely not fit me. Clean the armor. All right. Yeah, that's definitely the part of the straw. Try to find a crap. Brain's not working. Someone help me. I'm looking for something that you can take artifacts to. That's it. I want to find a museum. Yep. Yeah, the artifact I'm talking about is the skeletal robe. I start making my way up to there. Would help. And would I have seen him walk away from the party? So I would have stopped and followed him, seeing as we're still not back inside the main portion of the city. And of course, I had just activated my Edric sight. So, do I see anything magical? Yep. Don't touch it, whatever you do. And I cast Mage Hand. I'm using Mage Hand to have the Mage Hand grab it. Yeah, pick it up without anybody actually touching it. Oh boy, I think we need to get the Red Guard here. It's just the head. I thought it was a decapitated head. Except one of our own just went to get the Red Guard. Now, I am going to try to do a persuasion here. Why would you think that, yes, the Red Guard may have been with you, stabbed you, but why would you think the Red Guard, who are supposed to protect the people, are wanting to take assassination jobs when they are meant to protect the people? Exactly. So when the actual Red Guard gets here, we can hopefully get it all cleared up. And on top of that, if the Red Guard does attack you, I will try to persuade them to not and try to find out what's going on. And I have a plus 5 and I got a nat 1. We both got nat 1s. Which one of us did he hand it to? Because both Gendal and myself were there. F. about time you got back. We healed him slightly, and before you could get back, he took off. Yeah, he ran after saying that the Red Guard that was the Red Cloak that was with him attacked him and threw him in here. I don't know what's going on. That's what he said. Oops. Well, yeah. I completely forgot to unmute the desktop audio for the stream. Oops.
Uh-oh. Well, at least they can hear us now.
Yep.
Well, you're doing this every time.
Well, and folks, you didn't miss anything. He did not say anything interesting again this show.
No, it's you guys they couldn't hear. They could hear me. They just couldn't hear you.
Well, then we're sorry you missed all the fun, interesting things.
So do you give a description of the man?
White, 50.
Or 50-ish. I guess I should say. Do you give an accurate description? Do you hold any details back?
The only thing I say is when he got up, we could tell he was an elf. Full blood. But other than that, no real discerning features.
All right. Just go ahead and make a deception roll.
All right. Let's see. Where is it? There it is. And that's with a plus three. Because I'm telling the truth, half truth, but
yeah, well, I can give you guidance just to.
So blatantly using magic in front of them as you're trying to explain something is probably not going to be...
Yeah, that would not be wise. He knows I'm not telling the whole truth.
Looks at you, he says, I think you know more about this elf's description than you are letting on.
All right. Yes, I do. He was wearing a tattered cloak or something?
Yeah, tattered overcloak over more regal finery.
And that's basically what I say.
Okay.
The Gam Schultz, I saw nothing.
And how tall was he?
I don't think I caught that.
Yeah. He could be anywhere from 5 feet to 6 feet.
And he basically continues to press you for details. So do you answer truthfully, or do you try to evade?
Truthfully. I would try to evade.
I'm not going
All right.
make them mad at me. And then them finding out what I'm a descendant of.
All right. So
I don't know how they'll react to that.
Have to just go around announcing it loudly in public at every possible opportunity.
That's awesome.
He takes it once.
This.
You also openly wear the symbol everywhere.
Actually, right now I'm not.
I think that's so funny.
He takes the information down. He says, "Oh, where are you all staying, just in case we have more questions about this incident?"
I don't remember the name of the inn.
I wrote it down. The Grinning Goblin Inn.
All right. So he adds that to his notes. And he says, stick around town for a little while, just in case. And they turn and they head back towards the garrison.
By the way, I do have the party notes up on my right screen. I just, for trying that, he in character forgot.
Not even been a full day.
A lot of stuff's happened.
As he leaves, I'll show Aaron the envelope and say, "Well, looks like I've been promoted from squire to guest, as all of us."
All right.
It looks like we'll be joining you tonight.
Wonderful.
And then I tell Aaron
the
guy's name.
Okay.
Would I recognize the name?
So, yes, you will recognize the name as belonging to one of the less prominent but still influential noble houses. And
what was the full name?
It is...
It's a mouthful. That's all I know.
Yeah, let me look.
I wanted to post it in the party notes so we can...
Lord Taristio Sil Wagler. Wahgeler.
I was way off on my
spot. Alrighty. I'm gonna just guess.
Oh, right. I can copy and paste.
Yeah, you could.
And if I can find what page is this? 148.
Looks like we have plans for tonight, and look, I think we need to get the right attire to go to this party. I'm so glad we found these skeleton robes.
These nice robes.
I am not wearing those robes. I'll be wearing my fine clothes. Thank you.
Yeah, I have fine clothing. I had wanted to try to take it by a
tailor.
Yes. Which would you all like to join me in getting some?
I'll join you. I don't have any.
Sure.
Yeah. Before we do, let me sell the three short swords, so we have some extra gold.
Sure.
All right. I posted the name in chat.
Yeah. And then I put it into the party notes section. So.
Okay. So you all continue up to the fish gate. You head through, and on the inner side, you find a place where you can rent a carriage that will take you back to the hotel. Cost for that would be 7 silver.
For everyone?
For everyone.
Mm-hmm. We just take that out of like party gold.
Sure.
That's what I'm saying.
Yep.
So, could anyone find each? Actually, no. Do I want to? How do I want to heal this?
Oh.
Because I do have some natural healing of my own.
Well, if you're at 2 level 1 spell slots left, I could throw you a healing word.
Here, let me try mine first and see how much that gets me, just because I do want to not have open wounds as we go to a party.
That's probably a good idea.
So I'll use second right. wind.
Yeah, that is so last year.
So the carriage starts taking you across the town. It makes a quick stop at a blacksmith shop where you can sell the short swords if you wish to do so.
Yes.
Yeah, I'll sell.
Right.
I will sell mine as well that I had picked up.
Okay.
Also, how much for these? How much for this robe? Just curious.
How much would you be able to sell it for? Be able to get about 2 silver for it.
Okay, I'll hang on to it.
Okay.
How much to make alternate?
How much what?
How much to make a alteration to it? So obviously this is not going to fit me.
Well, this is a blacksmith. This is not the fine place.
You need to go to the tailor for.
That's the third word. So I'm shooting the bullet here. We're in the gun.
All right. I'm just tossing it. What? So the short swords are sold, and the carriage continues on its way, bringing you all to the inn. There is a tailor shop a couple of blocks away. So you all presumably collect whatever you will need for the party, and then head to the tailor shop?
Yep.
Okay. Does anybody look at the pouch that you were given?
Yes.
Okay. Inside the pouch, you find 400 gold pieces.
Oh, fuck.
Amazing.
Damn.
So I will let you all decide if you want that in the party fund, if you want to split it up, how you want to
party
deal with that. Party?
We'll be all for the outfits for the ball tonight. Shall we draw that from the party funds? From all of this 400 gold that he just gave you guys to attend the party?
I personally don't need to use it because I've got fine clothes. So I just might need my clothes to be patched up. That's about it.
Well, I mean, just go ahead and put it in the party fund for now. And once we see how much our outfits are.
All right, so you get to the tailor shop and find that you will be able to rent finery that would be appropriate for this event for 70 gold each. Because this is one of the most high-end events of the year, other than the Wiltimer Ball.
Only 3 of us are going to be renting because they have theirs, so that's 210. Right,
well, so yep. I would like though to see if I could get my fine clothing updated and make it finer.
Yeah.
So they will be able to do that. However, since it would be a rush job, they would charge you 100 gold for that.
Might as well just rent.
Well, so here's my thing. For an extra 30 gold, I can have permanently fancy clothing versus...
Yeah, one time you straight.
Right? Like... If I have to go to another ball in fancy clothing...
You're going to wear the same outfit?
It's called piecing. Also, historically, you would wear the same outfit to many balls.
Well, I mean, warriors and stuff like that, but I mean, I thought the ladies would not. Weren't they supposed to?
This is combining it with my male. My outfit is a combination. And do you have any idea how expensive...
Are you wearing the dress on top of your male or under the
male? So it's
just a skirt underneath.
So here's my thing is, how I'm envisioning my fine clothing is more combining it with armor to make the armor look ceremonial of a sort.
Full plate mirror, but dangling earrings. Yeah, I mean, yeah, if you want to have it fixed, that's fine.
Okay, so that'll be 100 gold for Aaron then. The three of you that are renting, you all rent for the 75.
If that was 70.
Sorry, yeah.
Trying to sneak an extra 15 gold out of us.
Yeah, so you'll rent at 70 gold, and...
Gendel's thinking we should be a squire and save the party 70. No.
Yeah.
I'll rent it.
All right. And somebody had something that needed repaired? What repairs were needed?
It was Stevel.
Stelvar, just having Stelvar. The fine clothes repaired if needed.
Okay.
It's essentially what my... picture shows is how my fine clothes look.
Okay. So yeah, there's some wear and tear and stuff that they can fix for 20 gold.
That's fine for me.
Alright.
Might as well take that out of the party fund too.
That's going to leave us 70 from the 400 plus what we had before.
Yes.
Just doing a quick Google of imaging, just as a kind of basic example of what I'm talking about.
Okay.
Not exactly this image, but what I'm saying, like, it's combining art, it's combining the armor while making it look, and cloth to make a fancy, formal look. That, like, something along that, without having to get fancy ceremonial armor.
Your dress armor.
Too far off the skirt comment.
That's not exactly what she would be wearing, but something along the lines of...
A cross with a skirt, basically.
And, like, possibly a tunic or something over the armor. Just in a fine, very fine, formal... Yeah.
Makes sense. Alright, so it takes them a couple of hours to get this all done. It is 6:30 as they hand the clothing over to all of you. So, you all head out directly to the party, or have anything else that you are looking to do?
One thing I was going to say real quick is, how much gold does everyone have? Anyone have under 10 gold?
Oh, let's see. I currently have 2 platinum, 3 gold.
Okay, so you're good. Who said
21 golds.
I have 13. I should be
13.
I have 24 gold.
All right.
Is it 22?
I was gonna say, if you want, do we want to just everyone take 10 gold out, so then everyone is like to at least 20.
Oh, so you're taking 50 away from the 70 remaining and adding.
Well, 20, no, 20. we actually got 196. Because it was 70 on top of the 126. So we've got 196 gold in the... party fund right now. Yeah, 196. So we take 50 off, so that leaves us 146.
Yeah, but, I mean, I'm good either way. There's not much.
Because it's just, I mean, I'm fine right now on it, but I know that sometimes if you want to have...
If we get split up and you need something.
Yeah.
Okay, fair enough.
So everyone take, put 10 gold in your system, and then we'll subtract 50 off of the...
All right.
Done.
And...
Whoop. Now I have 23. So did we want to stop by that the Magic University, or go straight to the ball?
Yes, we should go to the Magic guy. Since we paid for all this shit, we should probably see what he's up to.
Because we still got a little bit of time.
But before we go there, did I get my alteration to the robe I got?
To the robe that you got from the basement?
Mm-hmm.
What were the alterations you wanted done to that?
I just wanted an alteration so that it fits. Doesn't look half-assed.
They tell you that they can get that done for you in a couple of days, but they're kind of pressed with getting things ready for the party.
Okay, no problem. I'll come back then.
Okay. And they give you a price of 1 gold for that.
Okay. I guess I'll come back when you guys are less busy.
Okay. So, heading towards the temple, then?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
Right. That was the Temple of Magic, which is...
Temple of Magic, I think Father Bo was his name, where we left the bowl with him to see if he found out anything.
Alright, so you make your way out of the shops and down to the Temple of Magic. You head inside to talk to the father, who kind of tells you that they really haven't found anything else. He had a couple of leads from some things that he knows students both at the Temple of Magic and some other magically inclined, especially that silly Bard College down the street, have used, but this is much stronger than that. He's very sorry he wasn't able to get any more detail, but all of the leads that he had ended up not panning out.
Okay. Also, I'm going to say we recently bought some skeletal people wearing, and I'm going to pull out just one of the robes and saying it was wearing this robe. Would you know of where we might find people? Because we think someone was killed. We want to make sure that whoever was notified.
Well, I... definitely recognize the symbol on the cloaks. It's from very early in the kingdom. There are some magical wards that produce guardians wearing these cloaks.
Oh, so it's not like someone was killed.
No, it looks like this was magically generated or magically preserved for acolytes that were entombed somewhere to become perpetual defenders of that place.
Okay.
It's believed that some ancient tombs had protections like this. Along with, you know, there are a few other locations as well. It's not specifically tombs, but that's where they're most often encountered.
Right. Well, good. Thank you for the information.
Of course. If you're looking for a name, by the way, supposedly this magic was created by Arlen the Constructor. So I don't know if that gives you any of the information that you're looking for, but that's what I know.
Arlo the Instructor?
Master Arlen the Constructor. He built many of the magical constructs, helped in the construction of the city, developed a lot of defensive wards and weapons and things in the early kingdom.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure. That,
yeah, I'm reading the lore. That was like 2,000 years ago, right? Something like that. I don't remember.
So, what do you all want to do now?
Get changed and head to the party.
All right. So, presumably you would have gotten changed at the tailor shop.
Yeah, I would have just said
you wouldn't be.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So you start making your way. Party. Actually, hold on. You're here. Here. Winding your way through the lower town. As you arrive here, Aaron and Gendel. Oh, wait, no. Sorry. Pyre and Gendel. Go ahead and make a perception check.
Okay.
16 for Gendel.
Okay.
21.
21. So, Pyre, you notice as you're walking along the old wall, a very slight glimmer. And as you look closely, you see very small graffiti carved into the wall at about waist height.
Okay. And where is it? Right where you're...
Yeah, right where the token is.
Hang on. All right. All right. Yeah, I'll lean over to Stevlar and just kind of point out, like, oh, look, something's been scribbled onto the wall back there.
Hmm. Were you able to read it?
How far away are we?
You're basically walking right alongside the wall.
Oh, okay.
Which is really the only way you were able to see it.
Is it something that I can read?
It is not.
I take a look at it with my ability to comprehend all written language.
Okay. And you recognize that this is an ancient dialect of Common. Written in ancient glyphs, and you can tell that this was engraved probably 1 to 2,000 years ago.
What does it say?
Before the kingdom even started. And it says, find the hideout at the top.
Okay. There's only one thing I can think of for that. And I do say it to the party, what it says. And tell them what dialect of Common it is. And I give my thought that it could be the place that is the Sunken Temple or whatever it is, Sunken Tower.
I mean, does it look like it's been there a while, or does it look like it's been more freshly carved?
It looks like it's been there since before the kingdom was made, correct?
Yes. This wall predates the kingdom, and this looks like it was engraved many centuries, probably more than 1,000 years ago.
Can Kendall just look up and see if there's like a tall building that catches his eye? Like, is there like some monument or anything that just stands out around this area?
Go ahead and make a perception check.
Oh!
That would be a natural 20.
So, the only tall... The only really tall structure other than the minarets of that kind of mark the wall itself is the Tower of the Speaker that's over here. But looking up at the wall, you do see some weird wear pattern in the aged parapet up above.
There's something we should check out.
Yeah, put that out.
Knowing what I know about the history of the city, would I have any thoughts on, like, any idea what this could be more specifically referring to?
So, you know that the early races that inhabited this area were enslaved and forced to construct this wall and some ancient buildings that have been lost to time. And every once in a while you've heard that slave graffiti is found. There were rebel groups that sprang up from time to time, although generally they were wiped out in short order.
Nah. I suggest that after we're done with this party, we go to bed, and then when we get up, we go check that out.
Okay. And guys, I'm going to book out a little early. I'm kind of feeling a bit, and I got to get up early in the morning.
Ready? All right.
So later, Piper.
Catch you later.
Have a good night. Catch you later.
Later.
All right. So everyone is continuing on to the party then?
Yep.
All right. And you pass through the gates and find yourselves at the Rose Garden.
The Rose Garden.
It's a garden of roses. I bet this park smells very strongly of roses.
Not really. What about what smells like beer? No, huh? Must smell like beer. Well, her rose facade could be Williams.
Right, and you find yourself in front of the west gate leading into the park. Standing in front of the gate are two royal guards who stop you as you approach and ask for your invitations.
I will hand over mine and give them a half bow.
All right. He says, ah, yes. Madam Wiltimer, please follow the path to the left and speak to the guards there.
Of course.
Oops, they open the door for you. Okay. And everyone else?
I'll hand over my pass as well.
Which has okay. All of us.
You'll say, ah, yes. Guests of our distinguished hosts, please enter and enjoy.
Thank you. And I do a courteous bow as well, and then walk in.
Okay. Presumably everyone is following?
Mm-hmm. Yep. All right. I was walking with my head bowed, head down, all up. That's fun.
So, as you get inside, you see that the path splits to the north and the south. To the north, you see that there's kind of a separate area to the park, the entrance to which is being watched by a pair of guards who stop Aaron as she approaches. They say, state your business.
I'm Sir Aaron Wiltimer, and I was directed to come this direction.
Ah, of course. Please, step through. And they open the gate and let you through.
Did they give me any more direction than that?
Oh. Cool. And when you step through... looks like I didn't put them there, but you find several elves kind of milling about, talking, and up at the end, basically in this area, you see that there has been a large gong set up. And what appears to be a servant standing next to it. Along the back wall, you see several wards have been placed kind of in front of the hedge wall that makes each one softly glowing red.
Would I have any idea what they might be?
Go ahead and make an Arcana check.
So, probably not.
Too bad I'm not up there with you.
Oh. Wait,
so, sorry. Yep.
Sorry, I just missed the last 2 minutes. Was Arn escorted to like a different area of the party?
Yes.
Got it. Sorry about that.
So, you recognize a couple of them as one of them is a protection against scrying. One of them is kind of a barrier ward to prevent entry from, you know, anybody from kind of climbing over the back wall. And it's intermixed with a few ward, a few copies of a ward that you've never seen before. But it looks to you quite ancient. and kind of primitive compared to words that you commonly see.
All right.
Again, too bad I'm not with you there.
So, for everyone else, what are you all doing?
Exploring.
Okay. So as you come in, you see that the courtyard, the main area, is filled with people, all dressed in their finest clothes, all appear to have very noble bearing. There is a group of singers in the gazebo in the center of the park singing. And you can tell that they are representatives of the Bard College. There are a few guards scattered about inside as well. And you notice that there's a access to another section of the park to the south. And the lake kind of snaking its way through the northern part of the park.
In fact, I'm doing more than just exploring. I'm also looking for the guy that gave us the invitation.
Okay. Go ahead and make a perception check to see if you can spot. So you do make out... you do make him out standing... standing over here with a very attractive younger woman on his arm.
Hmm.
Going to follow?
Why, hello there, Lord. I'm not going to try to say that name.
Ah. Okay. Ah, my saviors have returned. I cannot tell you how indebted I am. I so appreciate your assistance earlier. And as he is talking, you are able to tell that he seems quite tipsy. The hand that is holding his glass of wine is kind of wavering and tilting a bit, as is he. But please let me introduce you to my wife, Lady Rasilda Silwaggler.
And another one of those names I'm not going to try to pronounce.
She kind of gives a slight curtsy to you.
And I do a slight head bow as well. Say, it's nice to meet you, my lady.
I most appreciate the assistance that you gave my husband earlier. If it weren't for your assistance, I can only fear the worst of what might have happened.
Now, you, looking back at the Lord, you did say that you were going to, what was it, explain what was going on?
Unfortunately, I have tried to come up with some explanation of what happened, but I can't imagine why anyone would try to attack me. I don't believe I have any enemies.
There's one reason why. There's one reason. You're a lord. People randomly want to hurt.
There's another possible reason. I don't know if they are prevalent here in the kingdom with the red coats and so forth, but might be someone who has a hatred of elves.
Hmm.
I don't know why one would, but since my family has not been in the kingdom for generations.
I have to admit, I am completely puzzled, to be honest. There haven't been any threats that I'm aware of made against me, but the Royal Guard are looking into it. Hopefully, they will get to the bottom of this soon. Well, that... In the meantime, we should party and enjoy the festivities. No?
Hear, hear. In any case, perhaps be a bit more careful with the guards that you hire. I mean, we're also available should you need assistance in the future.
Well, I will absolutely keep you all in mind.
You're sure. You have 5 gold per hour.
Out of...
A little more than that.
Out of prayer. Hey, can we stick a dream pastry on fire?
No. Where is it you all are staying in case I have use of your services?
Over at the Grinning Goblin Inn.
Oh. Not exactly the best neighborhood. I have a friend who runs an inn in the Upper Sea called the Lucky Leap. I'll see what I can do. Maybe arrange some free accommodations for yourself and your friends.
That would be nice. But right now, one of our companions, she went into another section, and she's, I think, a Wiltimer.
Ah, interesting. Fine company that you keep. Yeah, they are. They are co-hosting this party. They're having some ceremony or meeting or something for the family back there. We don't really get involved with that, but hey, they're helping with the costs of this party. So who are we to turn away their generosity?
Now, I do have one question for you.
Sure.
What do you know of the first king of this kingdom?
Well, I don't know a ton. Is there something specific you're looking to learn? I might at the very least be able to point you in the right direction.
I'm mostly trying to learn more about his lineage.
Well, it's kind of fallen into disrepair over the years, but typically the best place to find information like that, probably the Temple of Knowledge. They maintain genealogical records for the kingdom as a whole, as well as more detailed for the city.
Thank you. I may have to check them out tomorrow.
Of course. Now, on the flip side, up in the more noble air. Evan, as you walk in, a young but distinguished woman in very fancy robes walks up to you and says, "Ah, Aaron, our cousin, welcome. I take it this is your first time coming to one of our gatherings.
I was never able to make it the last, when I previously spent time in the city, for it was very rarely long, and it was long ago indeed.
Yes. Well, even within the family, invitations to these gatherings are quite hard to come by. But you have done a good job of representing the Wiltimer name during your time in the country. So I am glad to welcome you. Please, the first course is going to be served shortly. Let us find a spot and we can discuss things. And she kind of leads you further in up to the, up into that area, and you see several of the other elves also slowly kind of making their way up there as well.
Oh, here he is. I can't see.
Outside with everyone else. As you are standing and talking with the Lord and the Lady, food is kind of passing by. You see servants carrying trays with wine, hors d'oeuvres. Does anybody take any food or drink?
Yes, I take both food and drink.
Yeah.
Okay. Maybe a better question. Does anybody abstain from food and drink?
I do. Penrith does.
Penrith does? Okay. And
this is the whole entire fucking pig thing. I'm not fucking touching any food from this area.
I mean, to be fair, right. This is a completely different area. We were kind of in the slums, and now we're in the noble quarter.
You still need to eat. I imagine Penrith has a bowl out, like empty bowl, maybe just put food in there.
So,
yeah, they still have the bowl, then. Wish I had the bowl of soup still. Have to get rid of it.
But yeah, I'm grabbing hors d'oeuvres, drinks as they pass by. Gendel has never had this fine food before.
Okay, and so as the first hors d'oeuvres kind of pass by, you take some, and most of it is the absolute best food that you have ever tasted in your life. The wine is a bit more of an acquired taste, but you can tell it's very expensive, but it's also very rich in the flavor, and it's a little... Oh, it's kind of overwhelming, the taste of it.
Did I...
Stelvar... Sorry, yeah, go ahead.
Can I make a check to see if the wine tastes funny?
Or if
something's...
Constitution.
Constitution check? Or save?
Yes. Check. To see if you, like, feel funny or off after you.
Five.
Hey, pretty sure it's fine.
Yeah. It's got earthy body, rich tones. It's great.
Taste strong.
It's strong, yeah.
Yes. And I'm not going to put words in Potter's mouth. We'll find out whether he ate or drank later. All right. So... Everyone who is with the Lord and Lady, go ahead and make a perception check.
Okay.
18. All
right.
and 22.
Okay, and let's see what Pyre would have seen. Okay. So, Stelvar is the only one that is able to see this. But, kind of, as he's watching the Lord's hand kind of droop a little bit, you notice another lady walk past. And you think you see her move her hands in an odd way over the top of his glass as she walks by and then moves past.
Lord, do not drink that glass. I just witnessed someone drop something in it.
Kind of looks at you a little disoriented, a little confused. Is, what, is here?
Yes, just who, now. Who? That woman that just walked by.
I can't imagine. And he kind of pours the glass out. Well, I can't imagine any of the lords or ladies gathered here would, but no such thing is overcautious. I will just skip to myself another. And he turns, chases one of the waiters. Well, staggers after one of the waiters to get a new glass of wine.
Can I make a, if I heard Stelvar say that, could I see what this lady looked like?
Yeah, if Stelvar points her out to you.
Mm-hmm.
So, tall human, dressed in a very fancy, low-cut white gown with long, curly black hair.
And I point to her. I go up to the Lord and point to her and be like, "Do you recognize her?"
He kind of looks over at her and kind of squints as he looks at her. You mean the one sitting in the middle, right? Yeah, I'm pretty sure her name is, I'm pretty sure she's Lady Victoria Violet. One of the most, beautiful, ladies, in waiting, still filtering through her many, many suitors, last I heard. Why, taking an interest in her? He kind of nudges you a little bit.
Well, it's not in that respect. It just seemed a little suspicious what she did.
Well, I can't speak to that, but I can't imagine she would, somebody of her high standing would try to attack a fellow noble.
I turn to the lady, his wife. Do you know of anything that he might have done that could cause hostility?
She kind of looks to think about it for a minute and says, I honestly can't. I mean, his business dealings are above board. He, you know, he arranges social events like this. He's looked upon quite kindly, as far as I know, by the people of the city.
I will, since I am being very suspicious of what's going on, activate my invocation Edric's sight, and I look towards that lady that I caught pretty much roofing his drink or poisoning it or whatever it was.
Yeah. Okay.
At the same time, I whisper to Stelvar and Panrit, say, perhaps you should keep an eye out and maybe follow her. Who knows what she's up to.
So, yeah, you see her kind of... Yeah, we're going to use this one. You see her making her way over towards the southern section of the park.
I would keep a distance and follow. She seems suspicious.
Do I see anything magical coming from her using my Eldritch sight?
You do not.
One of us needs to stay here, just in case.
Not particularly stealthy, so perhaps I would stay here.
Alright. I still can't cast invisibility on myself at the moment, but I stealthily follow her.
Go ahead and make a stealth check.
Alright. I just barely beat her with that.
Alright. So, you follow her into the southern area. And it is 9:54. This may be as good a time as any to pause and to be continued next week.
You all right?
Yeah.
Sweet. All right. Cool. Awesome. Good game, everybody.